Welcome to V Plus U Academy. My name is Ashish Garg, and today we are going to learn the previous year questions that is being asked from the thick and thin shells. In the IAS examination, from thick and thin shells, around one or two questions is asked in the 3 or 4 years. So the importance of this topic is only of 2 to 4 marks, and from GATE perspective, this topic is not so important. One question is asked in the 5 years. So the idea of thick and thin shell is very simple, and the questions are very straightforward from this topic. You do not have to go into much trouble while solving the previous year question of thick and thin shells. So starting with today's topic of thick and thin shells. What is shell? Shell is a member whose thickness is very small as compared to its diameter. So question asked from this chapter is mainly from thin cells, in which case your thickness is less than 10 times of diameter of shell, or say cylinder or any sphere. For example, if you have this cylinder of diameter D and say thickness T, if this is the thickness of this cylinder, this is the thickness of this cylinder, you will find out that if the thickness is less than 10 times of the diameter of the cylinder to the 15 times of diameter of cylinder, this section is said to be thin section or thin shells. Thin shell. So basically the question asked is from this chapter is, if this is a pressure acting inside the cylinder, say you have a barrel, you consider a barrel, and there is a certain pressure P that is acting inside this barrel. So you have to tell about the hoop stress and the longitudinal stress present in this shell. If I have to show you what is hoop stress in this case, if you have this section, say we have this circular sections, and if I take this section, now in this cube section, if I plot it here, now this stress in the this direction, in the circumferential direction, is known as hoop stress. That is known as hoop stress or circumferential stress. Similarly, in the longitudinal direction, if this is our longitudinal direction along this length, if this is x direction say and this is y direction, then in the longitudinal direction we have sigma longitudinal. They will ask you to find out the value of sigma hoop stress and sigma longitudinal. Now the formula here is very straightforward. If you calculate it, it is PD by 2T, and it is PD by 4T in case of longitudinal stress. This is the change in pressure that is actually acting inside the cylinder. This is the pressure that we are talking about that is acting inside the cylinder. So the question asked in the previous year is, they will ask you to find out this hoop stress and longitudinal stress. That is first kind of question that usually being asked. Then from similar here, they may ask you to find out the ratio of hoop stress and longitudinal stress. That can be easily done by dividing these two. We will get equals to 2, because sigma hoop stress is more than the longitudinal stresses. So this is the another kind of question that is asked from here. Now the third kind that may ask you is to find out this thickness of cylinder or thickness of shell. How to calculate the thickness of shell member? This is the third kind of question that is asked from the thin and shell members. Thickness of shell member. They will ask you to calculate this by principal stress theory. That is principal stress theory. You know that these stresses, sigma hoop and sigma longitudinal stresses, are the principal stresses. And from principle of principal stress theory, we know sigma principle should be, that is say 1 or 2, sigma 1 or 2, that is the principal stresses, that should be less than yield stress of this member. So usually you have given the yield stress of the member and you have given the pressure inside, internal pressure acting in the center, and the diameter that is given to you, and you have to find out the thickness there. After calculating thickness, you must check whether this condition follows or not. If this condition follows only, then we can apply this formula. Otherwise, we have to go for our thick cylindrical members or thick members. So the validity of this formula is only for thin members. So this is the another kind of question that is being asked to calculate the thickness of the member. Now the fourth time kind of question that is asked is, fourth kind of question that is being asked is, this is asked in the previous year gate. You have given this cylinder of diameter D. This is given a cylinder of diameter D. This is given to you, and you have given a force P is acting on the outside of this section. A force P is acting, force acting at its section, at its section. Force P is acting at its section. A diameter D is given to you, and internal pressure P is acting. Internal pressure P is acting, whose value is P, whose value is P, and they ask you to find the value of this force P to have pure shear in the section. This is the question asked in the gate examination. So you have to make the magnitude of stresses equals. How is that? That is principal stresses magnitude. You have to make the magnitude of principal stresses equal. If this is the condition for pure stress, now you have the compressive stress and the tensile stress. You have to equate compressive stress equals to tensile stress of their magnitude. You have to equate their magnitude, and from there you will be able to calculate the force in the section, that is P. That is P. This is the another kind of questions that is asked from the thick and thin shell. If I tell you the solution of this question, we know that we have here longitudinal stress whose value is equals to PD by 4T. PD by 4T, and this is in tension, and this is in, the force acting is here in compression. What is the magnitude of stress here? If I calculate the magnitude of stress here, magnitude of stress if I calculate here, that will be P by A, and area you can see this is acting on the outside of this section, so P by pi times of D into T. This will give us stress that is acting due to compression, which is negative, and so net stress will be equals to sigma longitudinal minus sigma, or simply you can add, because we have already applied its sign convention, so it will be PD by 4T minus P by pi dt. P by pi dt, this is in tension, and if I tell you the hoop stress, that is equals to PD by 2T. If we equate this, if I say this is P, we have the same things here. We have internal pressure P and we have same force P also, so I am changing this to F. Now you have to tell the value of f. So this will also, this will be f, and this is also f. Similarly here, this will be our f value. So if we equate this, we will be able to calculate our f value. Now bus, now you have to keep one thing in mind, that your compression and tension magnitude should be equal. These magnitudes should be equal. So when you equate this PD by 40 minus F by pi dt, that should be equals to PD by 2t, but negative sign. But negative sign, why? Because we have to equate their magnitude. This is in whole in, this thing is in our, as I already told you, it is in tension. This is also in tension, but with negative sign, this will be in compression. This will be in compression, and we equate tension equals to compression. Tension equals to compression and their magnitude, from which we will be able to calculate the force in the section. So this is the fourth question, or fourth kind of question that is asked from the thick and thin shell. Now moving to thick shells. Now moving to questions that is asked from the thick shells. In case of thick shells, you have a Lehm's theory. A theory is given by Lehm's, which is followed in case of thick shells, because in this case your thin shells theory doesn't valid, or with the help of thin stress we cannot calculate the value of hoop stress and the longitudinal stresses. So here, in case of thick shells, if I tell you question related to thick shells, that is, here diameter is less than 10 times of t to the 15 times of t. Here diameter is less than 10 times of t. In case of thick shells, if I represent it diagram, represent it with the help of diagram, if this is certain length L, now in case of thick shell, this thickness t is greater than 10 times of greater than d by 10, that is the diameter of this section, that is the diameter of this section. So question asked are mainly from what is the variation of hoop stress in the thickness of this shell. You have been asked to find the variation of hoop stress in the thickness of member, in the thickness of cylindrical cell, I will say, in the thickness of cylindrical cell. So how do you solve this? This is solved using Lehm's theory. This is given by Lehm's theory. Lehm's theory proposes to find out the hoop stress. By this theory, you have given radial stresses value, that is equals to b by r square minus 1 a, and hoop stress value, that is equals to b by r square plus a. From these two equations, you will be able to tell about what is the variation of hoop stress inside this section. So if you solve this, we need two boundary conditions to solve this, and we also have given boundary condition here. We have this P internal pressure acting in the section, so we know at R equals to R internal, we have pressure equals to PI, that is our internal pressure, and we also know that R is equals to R outer, we have P equals to 0. So from here we will be able to obtain the value of radial stresses, and if once we know B and A value, we can calculate hoop stress. So this is the question that is usually being asked. And if you see the variation here of hoop stress, you will find out that its variation is something like this. This is hyperbolic. This is hyperbolic variation. This question is being asked, what is the variation of hoop stress inside the thickness of member? Is it parabolic, hyperbolic, straight line, or something else, or none of these you can say. So these are the four options given to you, and you have to tick hyperbolic variation that is present in the thickness of this member. So this is one question. Now the second question that may ask you, what is the value of A and B if P internal is greater than P external? What does that mean? If you have the internal pressure is greater than the external pressure, if this is P external, which is in this case equals to P atmospheric, which is equals to P atmospheric. So this is given to you, and now they will ask you what is the value of A and B, that is positive, negative or zero. They will ask you that if A and B is positive or negative or zero. If P internal, now the solution is, if P internal is greater than P external, if P internal is greater than P external, then in this case A and B are positive. A and B are positive values for hoop stresses. But if P internal is less than P external, that means A and B are negative value. That means A and B are negative value. So this is the another kind of question that is being asked from the thick shells. So this is our second kind. So overall, these are the kind of question that is being asked from the thin shells and the thick shell member. I hope you understand what I try to convey here is, when you start reading your concept, try to focus on these parameters, how to calculate your hoop stresses and longitudinal stresses. So thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day.